Hi there, I am Adam Kirbas, and this is another episode of my podcast. We are here in Ordu in Turkey. This is a town in the Black Sea region in northern part of Turkey. It is August, a sunny day, and we are still in the pandemic. I hope that you all are doing fine. However, we will continue where we left off yesterday. So, and this was we left with. We are talking in general. I mean, let me recapitulate. I mean, we are talking in general why you watch, not only why, but as well as which characters on TV shows have appeal to you and why. So we were still there, and in the end of the last episode we talked about Grey's Anatomy, and especially those three main characters in the TV show. This was in to repeat: Dr. Weber, who is the chief, then Burke, who is then later cancelled due to some behavior of the actor. However, he plays a crucial role, so Dr. Burke, and then Dr. Bailey. And these three black Afro-American characters in the scene or in the TV show have a crucial point and have a lot of appeal in among migrant communities. So this is not only confined to Afro-Americans. I mean, I talked about some other TV show in the German sphere, Turkish sphere, Anfänger, but it would not be appropriate to talk about it because it is not likely that people in the English sphere, especially generally outside of Germany or Austria, this TV show is not very known. It is not even quite known within Austria or Germany for that matter. However, but for our purposes, Grey's Anatomy is enough. And then again, so we talked the last time about why, for example, Dr. Weber is some sort of maybe appealing to some Afro-American and some migrants. I mean, obviously there is a gap within the society. Obviously there is something in North America because this show is targeted on the English sphere. So you want to target a special group, special people, and then why, or to put it bluntly, it is Afro-American. They are not in or not likely in a leading position. So many companies, as well as many areas in public, this is not are not led by Afro-Americans. Also, you only see this in college graduates, and so these are facts, these are statistics. So, however, and I talked a little bit about it, and today we will partially continue. And this is, I mean, I talked about culturalism. I mean, of course, you some sort of in your counter culture believe that you are better than this mainstream culture, only think about body positive counter culture. I mean, we talked a little bit about it, and this means, yeah, that you are not partially, it always swings with it, that you are not shallow like those models, that you are, that you have inner values, and that you are so this girl next door, and so on, down to earth and more human, and so on and so on. So this is more positive attribute, and as well as if you are, so this is part of the counter culture, you some sort of make it more positive. And with migrants, I mean, you are excluded in a way from society. And we talked a little bit about it. I mean, if you are being considered as some sort of a reliability to the society, of course, then you think otherwise of it. I mean, and in that sense, you then assume you're once one of us, once one black guy or black woman would take charge, would take power, we would do a good job, and so on. And it is as this approach is very common among poor people as well. Imagine, I mean, the divergence or the difference between city dwellers and land dwellers. So people who grow up in the city, everyone always assumes, or at least this was the case in rural Austria, everyone always assumes that those people who grew up in the city, they are somehow sort of, they don't know what life is, they are partially debauched and so on. So this is a common prejudice. This is as well as in, you will find these things in Game of Thrones as well. I mean, the North, these people are down to earth and so on, and then all those peoples who live in King's Landing, they are all debauched and so on. So that is this, there is this some sort of prejudice, and this goes as far as wits as well. So imagine if you're poor and so on, then you think, yeah, those people on top, yeah, they have privileges or whatsoever, but once we get the chance, then we would do a better job, or if you assume, this is very common among migrants as well. I mean, once we are underprivileged, so once we get equal opportunities with all others, then we would accomplish anything and so on, more and so on. So, and this is some sort of, in a way, it is epitomized in Dr. Weber in Grey's Anatomy. So this black man, very capable black man who is in charge and who does a good job, because before he has some issues. I mean, this makes him human again. This is those issues, those failures, they make someone human. And then other people try to be the boss, but no one can really do it as good as him. So this is why this trope or this character arc may have so much appeal on viewers. And so it is not that just if you are Afro-American or if you are a migrant, you don't just want to see someone on top or something. I mean, this is what we talked a little bit of as well in culturalism or in gender culturalism. Gender, this is as well as that. It is of course that you some sort of have other values, that you have more moral values, or that you partially try to confine yourself to a moral high ground and so on, but nevertheless you want to be in charge, or not only be in charge, but you assume that you would do a good job when you would be in charge, but you are kept from doing a good job because of society and so on. And this is what you see then with Miranda Bailey in this character arc of Miranda Bailey. So she's actually doing a good job. She's sort of taking care of all the interns, but she did not get the chance in the first round to become a superior, so she was in a way disadvantaged. And then in the show you then see that she really lives up to that she can really accomplish this. So this is again some sort of a migrant trope, if you want, some sort of a migrant character arc, because in real society, if you're African American or if you're a If you are a Middle Eastern man Middle Eastern man, woman in continental Europe, you suffer partially from exclusions. You don't get those promotions you think you deserve. So that's, be very careful. There are lots of these things always have to do with your notion. What do you think is good for you? What do you believe is actually very important, however. But this speaks to many migrants as well as to many African Americans. So even though we are not really part of it, but yet behind the scenes, we are some sort of pulling the strings. We keep everything together, and it some sort of depends on us, or that we, despite the fact that we are never acknowledged. This is again a trope in this character arc of Grey's Anatomy. So there's a trope, so we are not really acknowledged. Someone else takes all the credits. People hate us because we are very diligent, so this always swings with it. So people are diligent, they are successful in that sense, but yet they don't really and then in this trope you can see more and more that she lives up to that she becomes this great surgeon who is a great inspiring mentor and so on. So then part of this group, this is very important. And because as a migrant and as well as an Afro-American in general, of course you are some sort of excluded. Of course you are some sort of creator counter culture. Nevertheless, you want to be part of this mainstream culture. Who wouldn't? Because this mainstream culture is as well as being accepted as different, being accepted as foreigner. So if we remember about these genders we talked about, then of course one thing why these counter cultures and subcultures, why they all develop and are being some sort of created, is because you are some sort of excluded, or in a way you don't think, or that you are being represented in a culture, so that you create or be part of a small niche, and then there your values in a way are transformed. So everything that's been considered as negative in this culture, for what reason whatsoever. I said many. I gave an example of Turkish migrants, so that they are some sort of being considered in Germany and in Austria as backward, as some sort of negative, that they do not integrate into society and so on. And then this is then being then transformed into a positive aspects. Now the migrants, especially Turkish migrants, they are family bound, they are pious, religious, adamant that fast and so on. And of course, and then in the very extension, they are more man and so on, more they are on a moral high ground. I mean, just to recall what we talked about it in that sense, however. And this is some sort of you can see in Grace and Tommy as well. Today I wanna talk a little more about female characters, because I mean, of course, you have to be aware. I mean, this is all what I'm talking about, what I'm narrating here about is all from a perspective of a heterosexual man. This is the perspective of a straight man. So, but however, this does not mean that we cannot talk about very important issues as well. And I wanna talk a little bit of about Friends as well as in Sex and the Cities. But before I do this, I mean, I of course do research. I mean, I of course do not just come up with all my ideas out of nothing. I mean, I watch some YouTube videos as well.